Hi guys, welcome. We've been totally mic live that entire time.
Yeah.
So
woo.
All right.
This is Roll for Shoes. This is the the second part of the beginning of our Extra Live marathon. We're doing this 24 hours all the way through till tomorrow, raising money for the Children's Miracle Network and through Extra Life. So all the donations that you guys give during these shows will be going straight to kids that and their families that need help with getting their sicknesses and various ailments taken care of. It's a great cause, and we are here to have fun raising money for it. So, for this show.
Thank you.
Right? I know. I'll be like, was that your dad sense going off?
Yeah.
That fridge door is open.
I'm gonna recuperate the whole stream.
So Dom is going
to post. Trying to air condition the whole neighborhood.
Right? Yeah.
I'm just gonna pull it open randomly during the stream.
Dom is going to post a straw poll in the chat. All right.
Done.
In the chat, there is a straw poll. You will be choosing what we are playing tonight. I don't know what we're playing. None of these guys know what we're playing.
No
prep
for this game.
A bunch of people sent. No prep. Unlike
I have
the other
fear.
Roll for Shoes games, done no prep. So everyone sent me a bunch of suggestions for the games on Twitter today. I picked the top five that really spoke to me, and we posted those there. So vote on which one you want to see us play while I tell everyone the rules. So this is Roll for Shoes. Roll for Shoes has about three rules, maybe. all of you start with a character sheet that just says do anything one. You all have the skill do anything one.
I guess I should write that
down.
Yeah,
you can write that down. It's a very important skill. So anytime you want to do anything, you announce it, and you roll for it. So you're going to roll one die because it's do anything one. If your roll beats my roll, you do that thing.
Cool.
So let's say you want to climb a fence. You say it, you roll it. If your roll beats mine, you climb that fence. If you roll a six, then you earn a new skill related to the roll that you just made. So if you were climbing the fence, you rolled a six. Now you have a skill maybe called climbing two. And then from then on, if you want to climb, you're better at climbing. So anytime you roll all sixes, you can earn a new skill related to what you just did. If you fail at something, you earn an experience point. Because just like in real life, failure is the best teacher. Mm-hmm. You can spend your experience points to turn your die rolls into sixes, not for succeeding. So you would still fail if you rolled like double ones. But if you want to spend two experience points to turn both of those into sixes, you gain a new skill. So you could get like a third level skill for that.
Failing with style.
Exactly. Failing forward. That's basically it. Those are the rules.
Cool.
There's a couple of other rules that might come into play, maybe, that I will make up as we go, but that's the gist of it. So your characters are going to evolve as we play, basically. We'll figure out who your characters are as we start playing. Just so everyone in the chat knows, there are some things you can donate for this game. You can donate for rerolls for the players, just like any other game here at Saving Throw. You can donate. What did we say? What are the other things they can donate for, Dom? Don't worry, it'll come to me. It'll come to me. I know.
We can donate for Jesus?
Yes.
Yeah. Well, for Jesus.
Actually, $25 for Jesus.
Oh, shit.
For $25,
we'll
you can
bring him out. He's sitting in the back.
NPC into the game. So you name the NPC, and I will roll on my handy dandy NPC generator. And we will bring a random NPC into the game. You name them, I create them, and then I'm forced to bring them into the game immediately, if possible.
As long as Jesus is a chef, by the way.
Right, well, yeah. Your odds chef are Jesus. Uncommonly good for Jesus being a chef. I roll chef more than anything else. For every $50 that we raise during this stream, one of these two wheels will come into play. Either the wheel of genre change, which will immediately change the genre of the story we are telling, or the new Wheel of Madness, half of which affects people's characters at the table, half of which affects the players at the table. And I don't know if you could hear that, but Dom did some great spooky music just then.
It was spooky.
Thanks,
very creepy.
I think that's
more creepy.
I think that's
it was
the
very
gist
creepy.
Of it. That's the gist? Is that the gist?
It was very creepy.
It was real creepy.
Did I hit the gist of it?
Did you do the if we raise this amount?
The wheels.
You just did that.
The wheels, yeah. If we for every $50 we raise,
wait, what about Trumpy?
We'll roll a wheel. Trumpy?
What about Trumpy?
Trumpy is a special donation, and maybe some of you don't know this. On my page, there is a donation level. If you donate that amount of money, whether I am playing Roll for Shoes or in any other game during the marathon, my character will immediately and irrevocably become Trumpy. And I will play as Trumpy for the rest of that stream.
Can you get a taste of Trumpy?
We can't, no, no.
But what if people don't know? There's 300 people
he's
watching.
He's a four-year-old ex-camp director.
Right.
And recently fired security guard.
Yeah, okay, cool. That's canon. I wanted to make sure that was in there.
And he's very confident. I think that's about sums
it's
it up.
Totally worth it, chat. Like, grossly worth it.
Yeah.
To
add an NPC?
$25 to add an NPC.
And it goes to the kids.
To the kids.
It's all for the children.
And it's a great one to donate for if you want to see me sweat, because I have to bring in some random outlandish character immediately. Is this number on the screen the one that they chose? Or did you accidentally hit 5 with your elbow? It's gone.
We're professional.
Yeah.
So everyone, make sure you take a chance.
Going great.
Vote in the straw poll. While we wait for the straw poll results to come through, does everyone want to go around real quick and introduce themselves?
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
We'll start at this end of the table.
That's it. Who are you?
That's all we needed. Just that
I'm
smile.
Not really sure anymore. I don't drink a lot of caffeine, and I had a lot to be awake now, and it's not good. But usually I'm Mac Beauvais right now. I'm usually on Phoenix Dawn Command and also on the Misadventures game, and now I'm here with these people because I make bad life choices.
What? This is
or
a
great life choices.
Yeah. For the kids, yo. Mm-hmm. She doesn't like kids, apparently.
Yeah.
They are delicious, though.
Whoa! Whoa.
Only Tyler can say that, because the last time he played Roll for Shoes, he ate a child.
I did! You are right! I forgot about that. I got distracted by all the poop and the farting. But
yeah, you ate a kid. This
is going
to
be a great...
Which brings us to Tyler. This is Tyler, guys.
Yeah, hi, guys.
I like you.
Yeah, no. It's it got dark last time I played this game, so I'm going to be very uplifting. My name is Tyler Rhodes. I am one of the co-producers here at Saving Throw. I play on The Lost Brigade, and on Tuesday, we are going to be starting up our first real episode of Shadowrun.
Did you guys feel that?
missed everyone.
It's 3D!
So check that out. Come and watch me sweat, because it'll be my first time DMing an actual campaign of anything ever in my 37 years of existence. So enjoy that. Hi. Shut up.
Hi, everybody. I'm Gaurav, and you might see me from The Lost Brigade as well, and Maximum Minis, and Never Tell Me the Odds on Fridays. And I'm going to be I don't know what I'm playing yet. But
you don't?
That's who I am. And I'm going to probably shoot the camera, too. I might hit
No,
you
do it. That one's a lot more impactful.
No.
Just shoot back.
Whoa!
Just one.
No!
Whoa!
Just one. Just one.
Everything's fine. I am shook.
I know. I was there.
All right. Moving on.
Hi, I am Claire Max, and you've never seen me before.
Well,
yay!
Maybe they have, just not here on Saving Throw.
Yeah, I am. It's gonna be fun. I've never played this game before. It's gonna be great. Mm-hmm. And if all else fails, my hair looks good.
Yeah.
No.
So colorful.
You're sitting next to a unicorn.
Yeah.
Yes.
It's great.
I almost wore a unicorn kigurumi.
Oh man.
I have it in my car. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm just saying, I could go get it.
Does she have time?
What's the donation? The donation.
But I'm
level
a cat.
I mean,
I'm
if
a
it
cat.
Was up to me.
Awesome.
And you can like change his facial expression.
I thought that was like a nursing thing, because that would be perfect. You know, like
the no, cat.
I am not grown up.
It just has like a zipper, and you're just like, and then
hot, like,
yeah, but it's like for demon children, because it's a cat's mouth. It's just like,
inside
yeah,
of
it's
cat's
into
mouth.
The cat.
I want my children to like go up to random cats on the street and think they can nurse.
Yeah,
like,
let the cat barf
into
your mouth.
My children are cats, so that's true. I have three cats.
Like in nature.
Teach them to lion tame from a young age.
Right. So, you know.
On that note.
Hi, I'm Megan Caves, and I play in Black Bag and Misadventures with Mac here. And yeah, I do those things. It's fun. I don't know. But yeah, good.
I remembered another thing.
Thanks. All of that.
Uh-oh. Woo!
Yeah. Yeah. You guys, and this is very important. Earlier today, before we even started this, BSB Care donated to my Extra Life page, and he activated a secret objective for me. So, will soon be sharing that secret objective in the chat. My job is to try and accomplish that objective without any of these guys at the table realizing what it is that I am doing.
Oh, man.
It's not an easy one. It's not an easy one. BSB Care has given me a challenge, but I will see. Let's see if I'm up to it.
Huh. Okay.
But if any one of them call me out on what it is that I'm doing, I have failed to achieve that secret objective.
Okay. We do? Okay. Can we call you out?
Can we call you out?
Yeah, because chat knows. They know. Dom's telling him right now. He's spoiling it.
Oh, okay.
Nobody look at your phones. Don't be in chat right now.
Too late.
Don't sneak into chat.
So, yeah, I think that's all of it.
I'm ready when you're ready.
Are they, yeah, man. Are they still voting on the, do we have a clear winner on the straw poll?
Let's
roll for some shoes.
There's my pencil.
Oh, they're actually rolling.
I have too many guns, said no one ever.
We have a winner?
We have a winner.
Will you, through the magic of science, send me that winner now?
That is a contradiction, sir.
Is it?
The password.
All right, so this one comes to us from at Benjamin M. Dan.
Oh, I know that
on
guy.
On Twitter.
Yep.
He suggested this one.
No idea.
All right.
Sure. Let's jump right into it, shall we?
Okay.
Let's do it.
You guys, I'm just going to tell you a little bit, then you're going to name your characters.
Okay.
You guys are all carnies.
Yeah.
So name your character, and then get an idea of what it is that you do at this traveling carnival.
Okay.
And I'll tell you, the carnival has a slightly macabre, vaguely sinister bent to it. Okay. So I don't know if that influences your decisions at all.
Okay.
But just like, you know, quick name of your character.
I know what Mac is gonna be.
Actually, I don't know. Maybe I'll disappoint the chat. Maybe I'll impress them by being something else.
Something else?
When we have our names, are we going to, like, introduce ourselves? Or
yeah.
Are we, okay.
Yeah. Shit, just really tough. Quickly.
Okay.
So
it's a name and job, right?
Name and just like area. You don't have to do your exact job. Okay. Just like what area, like, you know, of the carnival you work in. Does anyone have their name and area of occupation in the carnival?
Yes, I think so. Yes.
All right, so we'll start over there and we'll work. Okay. So we'll give everyone time.
So
Megan,
my name was actually purchased for me by DJ Regular.
Oh,
thank
that's
you,
right.
DJ
oh,
Regular. Wow. So here's my name. My name is Contessa Elizabeth Franciscus, but none of you know me by that name. You only know me by Lisa Frank.
Really complicated, DJ Regular.
Franciscus. Yep.
And I am the face painter.
Face painter.
All right.
Nice. Every carnival needs
face
painter.
Very important.
My name is Rizabella. I named myself after the glamour cat from the musical Cats.
Well done.
And I'm an illusionist.
Ooh. An illusionist.
An illusionist.
Grizabella or Rizabella?
There is a G, but it's mostly silent.
Okay, so I'm gonna write
it's a floating G
apostrophe,
G,
yes.
Capital R.
There you go.
Rizabella.
Illusionist, which always looks like it has too many I's or too many L's in it.
Yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, I am Murphy Towns.
I think that's all we need to know.
That's good enough, yeah.
Murphy
enough.
Murphy Towns.
He is the snake oil salesman.
Snake oil salesman.
He sells all sorts of ailments. Mm-hmm.
Does he, or does he literally sell oil for snakes?
We'll find out.
Does your snake need to be oiled? When did you last oil your snake?
Sometimes they get dry skin.
My character's name is Buzz Mung.
Buzz Mung.
Buzz Mung.
Okay.
And Buzz Mung is the
Are you saying Mung or Mong?
Mung. M-U-N-G.
Really? Just want to make sure I hit it right.
Yeah, okay. And he is the electrician.
Electrician?
Okay. He has no electrician skills. Okay. He's self-taught, and he's kind of bluffed his way into this.
Well,
job,
he works at a carnival, so I think we all assumed he has no idea. Okay.
But he talks a big game.
He's got like 15 strings of Christmas lights plugged into one power strip. Like,
yeah, that's safe.
Or does he talk a big game? We don't know yet.
We'll find out.
Mac?
I am Julia Jones.
Julia Jones?
Jones.
Jones.
The
Juliet?
Infamous
Juliet.
Bearded Lady.
Yeah.
Oh, classic.
I'm sorry, is it Juliet Jones or Julia Jones?
Juliet.
Juliet Jones. Much more feminine name.
Right.
Yes. But, you know, the back half is Jones, so it sounds a little mannish. You got to balance it out.
Lady. Okay.
Isabella.
So, you know, it's been a normal day at the traveling carnival for you guys. You're in kind of like a small town in Middle America. Not very exciting. Some of you, depending on how long you've been with the carnival before, you've maybe been through here before. It's a kind of a crappy podunk area of the country. You can't wait to leave. So you had a decent amount of people attend carnival today for the area. Relatively successful day. Nobody died.
Yeah.
And Already, okay.
We can finally put up that one day without incident.
Well, flip it over.
Let's not
too hasty. Let's just savor that moment for the 5 seconds it lasts.
So you're all in the dining tent, because everything here is a tent. Mm. All things are tense. And you're dining. I don't know if you're necessarily dining together, but all of you carny folk all tend to take your meals at the same time, just for convenience sakes. Mm-hmm. And in walks your supervisor. Kid Carly has added an NPC named Jingle Jangles.
Good old Jingle Jangles.
Now Jingle Jangles is the supervisor of this carnival, and Jingle Jangles is a nervous undead.
Jeff. Damn.
Princess.
That's better.
Also works.
Jingle Jangles.
Jingle Jangles.
Undead princess.
Oh, boy.
Here it is. The story of Jingle Jangles. The nervous undead princess who supervises you at the carnival. She walks in. She smells. You can tell that she walks in before you actually see her because you can smell her coming in. Mm-hmm. She is not a lovely lady, but she likes to imagine herself as it. So, and you guys all know this about her. Yeah. She wears a flowery dress and a tutu, which does not do a whole lot to disguise her rotten flesh, which is falling off of her body. But you don't talk about that. Everybody knows that.
So conscious. Yeah.
Excuse me, everyone. Hi. Sorry to interrupt your meal. But we've had an incident over at the Tilt-A-Whirl, and we don't have anybody there to take care of it right now, so I'm going to need some of you to step up and take care of it. I don't know. I'm just going to pick at random. You five.
No. How does that concern us?
Well, everyone else is eating right now.
We're also eating right now?
Yeah, but...
Well, I've kind of lost my appetite.
Guys, I don't want to have to pull rank on you. You know, pull the whole, like, her royal height. I saw that. One of her eyes just starts trailing down.
Did you?
She just kind of, like, I'm relatively sure it's now looking a different direction. I'm relatively sure that I did.
Jangles, baby. Come on, we're having lunch. Why don't you come join us? You never get to have lunch with the staff.
Yeah, have a seat. Have a seat. Have
I am perpetually not hungry.
Why don't you come sit on my lap here?
Okay.
Can I roll for flirting?
Roll the flirt. So let's clear that out.
Oh man, this is going to be so funny.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
It can still fail.
Not looking good. Oh! Murdered.
Sure didn't.
Listen. It's never worked before, Murphy, and it's not going to work. Now. Okay? All of this is not up for grabs. Mm. So you five, if you could please take care of the Tilt-A-Whirl incident, that would be great.
This is a problem of face painter.
Listen, you can just go do
this
it.
This is
and
below
then you can
an illusionist.
Mm. Well, I guess I can at least snack on my beard crumbs as we head there.
Oh, yeah.
Delicious beard crumbs.
I'm going to pick out of that, too.
Do you want to roll to snack on your beard crumbs?
Yes.
Because you can do that.
Yes. Yes, let's do that.
Who was bringing up... You could... No, never mind. Sorry.
Yes, all of those things.
Yes. So roll. Roll for it.
Hey!
You did fail the flirt. Okay.
Yeah. Wow.
All right, so you snack on your beard crumbs. And you gain a skill. You gain a skill called... Resourceful Beard 2.
All right.
Resourceful Beard 2.
If there is any type of beard I like, it is a resourceful one.
Uh-huh. Right? The best kind of beard. No. So are you all, is anyone else doing anything else before you head over to the...
I will roll to attempt to become invisible so I don't have to do this stupid task. Wow.
Okay, now, serious question. Mm-hmm. Actually become invisible or present the illusion of becoming
convince
invisible?
Convince everyone that I am invisible.
Okay.
Or so that they're too embarrassed to call me on my lack of invisibility.
Okay.
You guys can see me?
Yeah, we have a mystery man situation here.
Do that thing. Ooh.
Oh, okay.
No.
Oh,
it's a tie. So you both succeed a little
okay.
and fail a little.
Okay.
So we'll go with your suggestion, actually. You stand up and say something along the lines of, ah, but how can you force to work that which you cannot see? And drop a smoke bomb.
Yes.
Which...
It's a pink glittery smoke bomb.
Dissipates, and you're still standing there. But everyone feels real awkward about it, and they all just sort of like half-heartedly pretend. They're like, oh, no. Where'd
you
guys she go?
See Grisabella?
Where'd she go?
She was just here.
She's such a good magician.
Yeah, so good.
And I just nervously slink backwards.
Okay.
Towards the edge of the tent.
She's not going to get out of that, is she?
No, she's not, okay? You all may be too embarrassed to point out, like, we can still see you.
Okay, well,
what?
Her tongue just kind of flops down
roll
on her
snitch.
Clavicle.
Yeah, roll a narc.
Roll a narc.
Well, I was going to say, I think that went a little too far, Jingles, but ugh. Fine.
Ooh. So, wait, you're rolling to narc?
I guess I am. It was demanded of me.
You successfully narc.
Sorry, that wasn't my intention. It's just that if I have to do it, we all have to do it, right?
Ugh, always the narc.
Okay, hold on. Because Kid Carly has donated $25, which on my Extra Life page I had said meant I would compose a heartfelt limerick of thanks for you.
Do it.
However, that was meant to be an ahead of time kind of thing, so that I would have time to do it. So, while we continue on with this, Kid Carly, I will give you the option to wait on your limerick until later on in the show while I think about it, or change that $25 donation into an NPC that you want to add to the game. So let Dom know in the chat what you want to do with that, and we'll just keep going, and
You're
I will
so
start.
Much.
I'm not, I'm fine.
No.
All right, so you kind of like hang your head in shame, and you all sort of walk out of the tent. Meanwhile, Jingle Jangles is finally finding her tongue and kind of getting it attached behind her teeth.
So sexy.
Just take care of it and then head back here.
I'm going to have a, I'm going to do like a cool scene where I just sort of like strap on my tool belt and just get on like my fingerless gloves. Just like in like a montage style, I have my headband on. So I'm just going to arm up.
Roll the montage.
Yeah, definitely roll.
Roll the montage.
Oh. Yeah, you can't just say you're going to montage.
Oh!
Yes.
So you suit up montage. Suit up two. And everyone just kind of stands there while out of nowhere this awesome guitar lick just starts pouring into the tent. Down, down,
down, down, down, down, down. Wrenches.
So good. Anybody else want in on this? I'm enjoying the show.
And then there's a thunderclap.
Wow, that was great.
You can't help but feel a little bit disappointed that he got this much attention.
I got a little upstage.
They basically just put on some electrician's gear. All right, so you guys heading over to the Tilt-A-Whirl?
Yeah.
Okay.
It better not be vomit.
Yeah, but I'm going to take my plate with me. Of food.
Okay.
Oh, wow. What else would it be?
You bet you can't narc on yourself. Paint?
That's against carnival rules.
Right? We can't eat in front of the customers.
We can't show them that we eat.
Yeah.
The carnival is closed down, you guys.
Oh, really?
Calm down, it's closed down right now.
Who's on the Tilt-A-Whirl?
Yeah, who gets
that's, you don't know.
This is weird.
You don't
this
know.
This is highly irregular.
So, you guys head over to the Tilt-A-Whirl. And the Tilt-A-Whirl operator's just kind of standing there by the Tilt-A-Whirl, like, at a loss. Like, taking his hat off, just scratching the back of his head. It's like, did Jingle Jangle send you guys over here to figure this out?
Yeah, what seems to be the problem here?
So, listen, I got three very lovely girls just will not get off of the Tilt-A-Whirl.
Yeah.
Won't get off the Tilt-A-Whirl.
Okay.
I kept trying to tell them. You know, ordinarily, like, you know, the normal amount of kids ended up by the old fortune-telling machine, wandered into the House of Horrors. Uh-huh. They haven't come out. But, like, these guys are not supposed to be here. It's not time yet for them to be on the Tilt-A-Whirl, right?
Yeah.
That's what I've been trying to tell them.
Do they have a Tilt-A-Whirl appointment?
What? No. It's just that, like, you know, the stars won't be right until later on at night. So, like, they're not supposed to be at the Tilt-A-Whirl yet.
Yeah.
But they won't get off. And, like, I've tried literally everything available to me, asking nicely.
Did you stop the ride?
I guess that could help. Yeah, hold on, I'll be right back.
Oh, wow.
But like, you should have, and he's still talking as he goes up into the booth. You should have seen him though. Like, I was yelling at them when they came by. And he stops it. And they just were like looking at me in what I can only assume was a defiant kind of way as they, you know.
Yeah.
Might it have been a nauseous kind of way?
Yeah.
Probably not. Mm. Probably not. So the ride suddenly like begins to slow down.
Stand back, everybody. I'll handle this.
And you do. Okay. And it does begin to slow. And you do see that there are two young women, probably teenagers, on the ride. Everyone's in their own tilt-a-whirl car. And one person who, at first glance, because of, I mean, all of them have hair of gold, you know? But one of them is actually not a young woman. One of them is Fabio.
Oh no!
Kid Carly has introduced an NPC named Fabio. Now hold on, this is not normal Fabio.
Okay.
This isn't that Fabio. Okay. This Fabio is a pathetic.
Oh no!
Tiny monster. With long flowing hair.
Okay. Uh-huh. Like you do.
Italian accent.
Why did you stop the ride? We were all on it and we're having a good time.
Dang. Says Fabio.
Gross. His nose isn't bleeding, is it?
Not yet.
Okay, cool.
Come on, it's time to get off the ride.
See, that's what I was telling him. And they're like, not getting off the ride.
We don't want to get off. We want to stay on the ride.
The other two agree, like normal human beings, that they would like to remain on the Tilt-A-Whirl.
It's good to want things, but you can't have this thing.
If I don't have to listen to you, you're just a lady with a beard.
Well, that gives her power.
Yes. Yeah. This is my magic beard.
I roll to throw glitter on her beard.
Do it.
In a magical way.
Do it. Not looking great.
Not looking good.
Oh, a little
bit. It's going to end up in her eyes.
No.
All right. So, I am a bad illusionist.
You get an experience. So she says, this is a magic beard, and there's a long, uncomfortable pause, and then all of a sudden, a puff of glitter just appears, like, beneath her torso, but, like, you whiffed that one.
But I do now have a point in throwing glitter, correct?
No, you failed. You get an experience point. Now, you could spend
that
experience
point
to
throw
immediately
glitter.
To gain a skill, if you want to.
I think I'll just hang on to it.
Yeah. Okay.
We'll just,
because there's not a lot of reason to hang on to experience and roll for shoes. So if you want timely glitter puffing.
You know what? I think that I do want that.
Okay.
Yeah. I feel like, why would I not want
we'll
that?
We'll call it glitter feats.
Glitter feats.
Glitter feats.
I like it. Two.
These two are with me, and they don't want to get off the children's world either. I mean, I'm not like their mother or anything, but I'm just saying, like, the three of us are going to stay here.
Well,
you're having a hard time taking him seriously.
It's broken.
Yeah, it just won't work.
It's broken.
Yeah. Gotta fix it.
I unplug it using my electrician know-how. I walk over to the extension cord and I pull
it's
it out
regular
of the
plug.
Socket.
It's just
does
a
it
plug.
Work that
it's
way,
a
regular though, let's find plug. Out.
Oh, yeah.
No! Oh!
So, you unplug the Tilt-A-Whirl, and the lights of it do go down, as do the lights for the entire rest of the carnival, all at once. You pulled the master plug.
What the hell, Buzz? What the hell?
You hear screams of confusion and noise from all around the carnival in the darkness. It's a cloudy night. There's a little bit of moonlight coming down, but it's really dark out here in the absence of glistening carnival lights.
I want to reach into my beard and pull out some glow sticks.
All right, roll Resourceful Beard.
Resourceful Beard.
Now, this is a two. You get to roll two dice now because it's Resourceful Beard 2.
Fancy.
Whoa.
Damn. I cannot beat that. She doesn't have experience to turn it into a skill, unfortunately, but... You pull out some glow sticks. You want one for everybody?
Yeah.
All right.
And different colors, too. I mean, obviously, I carry multiple colors.
Hold on, guys. Yeah. Hold on. Wait. So you go into your beard. You're pulling out one different color for everyone, I assume,
right? Oh, yeah.
So everyone make sure you notate which color glow stick you have.
Oh, perfect, yes.
That may or may not be important later. Okay. I don't know. BSB Care
Let's make sure they're actually different colors, though.
Yeah, green. Yeah, that, you're right.
I've got pink. Oh, darn. Okay, mine's purple.
I can purple.
All right.
Oh, yours is purple?
Yeah. Well, damn. Why don't you, I'll be red. You be
how, many, okay. How many colors are left?
Hold on, I'll wait for you guys to figure out.
How many colors are there?
Yeah.
Chartreuse. Does no one have a chartreuse glow stick?
No.
Does
not
go up at all, though?
It doesn't go up. It doesn't go up. You just used it successfully.
Mauve.
So does everyone have their glow stick color?
Yeah. Ochre.
Purple, pink. Ochre.
Purple, pink, yellow?
Yellow.
Salmon.
Green.
What?
I think she's red.
You got it.
She's
I'm red. I'm red.
She's red.
Okay.
What?
Oh, no. Hold on, guys.
For the kids. It's about to get wild.
Everybody strap in. So I'm going to make an executive decision here. BSB Care has engaged the Wheel of Madness. $50 was donated, so we will engage the Wheel of Genre Change.
What?
And another $50 was donated, so we will engage the Wheel of Madness doubly times.
Oh, no.
Oh, okay.
Two yes. times. So let's do the Wheel of Genre Change first. Now, Garav is looking a little gray here because one of the things on the Wheel of Madness is the Rhymanine. Don't worry about it. So let's throw the genre change wheel there. Can you give the genre change wheel a spin for me, please, so that I do not see what... Okay, now hold on. I have to try and throw this guy in here. Was I close?
No.
Okay,
no.
Hold on. Wait. Did that mistake?
No.
I can do this. Here's a four-sider.
Yes! Slasher!
That's actually pretty good timing.
Yes.
We are now in a slasher story.
Which works well with
it really
Carnival.
Does.
So let's remove the Wheel of Genre Change.
Hold on.
Wait, hold on. Let's take a very nicely framed photo of the Wheel of Genre Change.
Which filter are you going to use?
Now let's remove it.
I'm so excited.
Please use Juno.
Juno, please.
Can I recommend lo-fi, actually?
And then let's throw in the Wheel of Madness. So remember, three of these, I did not think this was going to get activated this much. Three of these things will affect you, the players at the table. And three of these things will affect your characters in the game.
Which are which?
Oh, yeah.
The green ones affect you at the table.
Okay.
The purple or chartreuse.
No, it's the other way around.
What?
It's the other way around.
Okay.
All right, yeah, other way around.
In the game, yeah.
Flip that.
Okay.
So, here we go.
Scratch that.
D4 works, so here we go. Did I get close?
Nope.
No!
We got this, guys. It's really hard to do without looking.
Okay.
Compulsion. Ooh.
Ooh. That one
didn't happen. Ooh. Okay, so compulsion. One of you now has a secret objective as well. Oh, wait, no, I'm sorry. Wait, compulsion is for people.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yep, okay. Let's see, I need a six-sided die here. One, two, three, four, five, six. I roll it again. Megan.
Me?
Megan, I'm going to write something down here on a piece of paper,
oh,
and I'm going to send it over to you.
Okay.
And then you're going to put that piece of paper beneath the camera so that everyone can see it.
Okay.
But
we
chat,
shouldn't
right?
look.
Yeah, you shouldn't
we
look.
Shouldn't
now, while this is happening, can one of you give the Wheel of Madness another spin?
Okay. Oh, right.
Okay.
Here, I'll hold
all
it.
Right, double
I'll
Wheel of Madness.
New, oh, okay.
Here, we got to hold it under here, though.
It is.
Spin.
Okay, it's fun. Nope.
Oh, man.
Good job.
Someone else
want
to go? Yep, I'm too far away. Someone
keep
else
going. You got this.
I'm too close.
I want Garav to do it. Here, roll this D4 again.
I'll do it.
Ooh, that
give me a
D4.
Okay. Mm, Claire!
This is why Claire we can't
Max.
Have nice things.
See, it's hard, right?
Claire minimum.
Wait, I got an idea.
Hey!
Oh, there it goes. Oh, compulsion again.
Uh-oh.
Do you want to do that twice, or?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, let's do it twice.
Look at me roll.
Okay, so here we go. Hold on. Let's see who this is going to affect.
This was your die. Sorry.
Six.
It was going to be something else.
Sorry.
It's Megan again.
You are double compulse.
Hold on. No, that's too many compulse. I'm gonna do someone else.
Me?
It's
me.
It's
okay.
All right,
okay.
So Megan, this is your compulsion. Nobody look at it.
Okay.
And then hold on. Let me write down Claire's.
You get a shirt
okay.
to the camera.
Are you compulsed?
Oh my god. Okay. Can you see? Can chat see it?
Bring it down a little bit. There you go.
There.
Just nobody look at it. Just don't look.
I can't see it from here.
I'm thinking about it though. That's all I can think about.
Look at that sick montage.
Shit.
It's your own sick, personal compulsion.
Sick montage. You know what your sick montage needs? Some glitter.
Yeah, I was gonna say next time.
Yeah. That would be.
Give it a try.
Well,
and,
off the
and now you have a sweet glow stick to go with it.
His sick montage is gonna be a rave.
Yeah. Claire.
Okay. 80s Nobody look at that. Slasher flick rave.
Wait, this is a slasher. Are we the bad guys? Because we're the carnies, right?
Okay.
But it turns out in a rare twist that we're actually
Can they
heroes.
See it?
Yeah.
Okay. It's like
I'll give them a moment to read it, and then I will take it
There's
away.
There's lots of stripes and swirls.
Okay.
All right, so we're now, that's a lot to process, so let's just recap.
Yeah.
We're in a slasher now. The lights went out, a colored glow stick was assigned to everyone.
Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm.
Suddenly, in a meta sort of way, you two players are afflicted with a compulsion.
Uh-oh. Mm-hmm. I feel compulsed.
So let's jump back into it. Everything goes immediately dark with just scattered moonlight from time to time as the clouds move across the sky. You hear screaming and the noise of running and confusion from all about the park, especially coming from the Tilt-A-Whirl, where it sounds like the three girls and one tiny pathetic monster, two girls and one tiny pathetic monster named Fabio.
With glorious hair.
Want to, yeah, oh, so great. Did not want to get off the Tilt-A-Whirl, are now screaming and thrashing at their lap bars and trying to escape. Now,
you're getting what you deserve.
I don't know what's happening. This is the worst carnival I've ever been to.
Yeah, well, maybe if someone hadn't pulled the wrong plug,
yeah,
be in this mess.
Although, let's be honest, this is probably the worst carnival.
We the only way
that is beside the point.
There's some pride, okay?
I think it's a good carnival.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank
Narc.
You.
The only way to get the power back on, we have to go back to the main breaker box, which is on the other side of the carnival.
Oh, yeah, roll for that.
Would you know a breaker box if it bit you?
Oh.
Roll for sick burns.
Roll for sick burns.
You could roll for
sick burns. Oh my god. Wow.
So what is that, finding breaker boxes?
You gain surprising electrical knowledge.
Two. Yeah, that makes sense. Oh shit.
And did you want to roll to
sick
burns?
I'm going
to
roll for sick burns.
Okay, now Tyler, you're going to have to resist this.
Ooh, you're going to have to resist my sick burn.
I do. I got to resist this.
You ready?
Yeah.
Ready for this?
Yeah!
Okay, so
I am an island.
You tried to sick burn him, but you failed.
I'm apparently really bad at everything.
That's okay.
Is what I'm learning.
Wait, what was the? It was the surprising.
That's true.
Surprising electrician.
It's all an illusion. You just think I'm bad at things.
Right. Now here's the thing, though. You can only use that when it's surprising that it's something that you would actually know.
Yes. This is most things related to being an electrician.
It is not electrical knowledge. Mm. It is surprising electrical knowledge. So all of you,
I will underline that,
are only seeing what is illuminated in the light of your multicolored glow sticks.
It's so red.
Mine's purple.
Oh.
Are we just announcing what color they are?
Apparently this is what's happening. I tie the green one to the bottom of my magnificent beard so that my hands are still free.
Okay.
That was a really good idea.
That is
a good idea.
Showing off
with your beard.
Will you roll resourceful beard? I imagine it's not super easy to tie something. Now you get to roll two dice.
Max beard, greatest asset we have.
Oh, that was a four and a three, so I can't beat that. So you do. You do tie that glow stick to the bottom of your beard. Well done.
Sure.
And then I get that nice creepy face illumination from it.
Oh, yeah. Well, and it's like filtered through the beard, so it looks kind of like an undersea effect. It's
exactly.
Nice.
Exactly.
You hear Fabio from on board the Tilt-A-Whirl go,
"Wait, who are you? You're not one of my friends."
And the noise of like strangulation or perhaps I don't know, having one's stomach forcibly opened and your intestines pulled out. It's hard to say. It's dark.
Mm. Mm. Mm.
Did someone hear intestines?
I know that sound.
It sounded
anywhere.
More like it sounded more like maybe a spleen.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, I think that might be worse.
The other girl on the Tilt-A-Whirl goes, "Fabio, what happened?" Same thing. Goes
we should. Do you think we should probably leave?
Yeah. Yeah. I think there's probably some more food left.
You know what? Uh-huh. I still have some glitter. No one will see us.
Wait, oh my god, guys, what's happening to my friends? You can't just leave us here. You have to help us. We're on the Tilt-A-Whirl.
I throw glitter.
I'll help you for anything.
Right, you should have gone off while you had a chance.
I throw glitter to disguise our exit.
Okay, do that.
And that's why you always leave a note.
I'm really bad at
everything. Wait, you have glitter. You have.
I have glitter feet. Oh, I roll two. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Well, this means we don't have to change the sign today, though. Yeah, right?
So you do.
Less work.
Less work. Yeah.
Less work.
Yeah.
You throw up a cloud of glitter, and suddenly you guys are all standing slightly to the left.
Yeah.
Of where you were.
Whoa.
No, you
won't. I don't even remember.
Don't get excited.
I'm actually getting a nice disco ball effect with the glow sticks.
With the glow
glitter.
It looks really cool.
It was exciting. And then you hear. You hear the sound of, that was the youngest one in curls. The one who
died. Wait, she had curls?
Yeah, the youngest.
You didn't tell us
girl.
That?
Well, so you guys didn't even ask anything about it. She died.
Her face earlier, probably ruined my face paint job.
Well, that doesn't take much.
I'm not okay with that.
It's hard to know, because you guys don't know if she was strangled or forcibly disemboweled.
Or eviscerated, yeah.
Maybe it's all right.
You guys are heading back to the dinner tent?
Let's, yeah.
Let's go anywhere but here.
Yeah.
It's my idea.
Yeah, I like that idea.
This is a drag.
Yeah, I'm running out of snacks. Let's go back. Uh-huh.
Okay, so you guys, the way that this area was set up with the copses of trees all around, all charming and rustic, meant that you guys had to set up the carnival in a slightly different pattern than you normally did. And now that all the lights are out, you're having a hard time remembering which way it was to get back to the mess tent as you guys kind of jokingly
We should probably go to the main generator too to reset it.
Oh yeah, you did mention that.
Yeah.
And that is apparently a thing that is true.
I tripped the breaker obviously on the 240 volt line. So you know, these things happen. Mm-hmm. It's not my fault.
Sure.
So we're going to the main generator tent?
Okay.
Yeah.
You know what? It's really dark. I got just the thing. Look, I got this potion, okay? It lets you see in the dark.
Where'd you get a potion?
Why do you have a potion?
I'm a snake oil salesman. I make all sorts of potions.
Wait. Would you admit that you were a snake oil
salesman? Yeah. Where do you think the power comes from? Snake oil.
You know what? I want to roll to see if you make potions or if you oil snakes. So if I win, you sell oil for snakes.
Oh, but he could also be a snake that is an oil salesman.
That's too many levels, I think. That's asking a lot of us.
Gone too far.
So let's just roll and see if you make potions or you sell snake oil.
Okay.
That's right.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What brand snake oil do you sell?
What if I make that a skill?
You can make it a skill.
What does that mean?
It means that you also tend to have potions.
Okay. Tend to have potions
you
too?
You have potions too.
Okay, cool.
Just potions.
To be clear, you do not sell those.
Okay.
You sell oil for snakes.
Okay.
What brand of oil for snakes do you sell?
What do you mean? Like, oh, what's the name of the brand?
I mean, you don't just sell like generic brand. Like, no one's going to buy generic, like, grocery store brand snake oil.
Over-the-counter snake oil.
Townsley Scales.
Townsley Scales. Oh, you make it?
Townsley Scales. Yeah, of course I make it.
Townsley Scales.
Yeah.
How does one acquire oil for snakes?
Yeah, wouldn't you like to know?
Do you have to milk a snake?
You gotta ring them, right?
Wouldn't you like to know?
They don't.
That's a secret I'll never tell.
I wouldn't like to know.
Yeah, I think I'm with you on that.
No, it's really cool. You do want to know.
No, I don't think so.
No, it is cool.
They don't want to
Actually, I'm kind of with really them. Cool. I'm not really interested.
No, it's guys.
Everyone, here. You're up.
Let's go back to my tent.
No.
Oh, no, I really don't want to do that.
Murphy, you roll, and everyone else oppose him.
All right. Six, come on.
No, you leveled it.
Ooh.
Okay. Oh, and here, you also did fail for that.
So oh, man, I got a two.
Someone gave me one.
I got a six! Yeah.
Three, wow. Only all of us actually, he beat all of us except
for me.
So you got a six.
I did.
So you are resisting him telling everyone about how snake oil is made. So you can resist unpleasantness.
I never said it was unpleasant.
It doesn't matter.
It's going to be real pleasant.
Now everyone else has to listen to him describe in graphic detail how snake oil is produced.
Gather around.
I sit crisscross applesauce.
Listen.
Yeah, so I'm going to leave.
Three out of fours.
I kind of want to hear this now for some reason.
I wonder if it works your beards too.
I've got many snakes. The best kind for oil? Rattle. Rattlesnakes. You ever hear that noise?
The rattling noise.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I think that's where they get their name, right?
I think so.
Okay. I mean, he
would
know.
I don't know. I'm not much for book learning.
Common misconception.
Oh, okay.
It's because of the oil. It's called Rattle's oil.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
It's inside. Okay. It's inside the rattle.
Could I use that for paint? Like some kind of new fancy
oil? Oil only. It's an oil only for oils for my business.
You're not hearing any of this.
Do you oil snakes
with it? I am filing my nails.
You can
oil snakes with it. I mean, you could.
You're categorizing it.
I think I want to.
No, no, you don't.
I'm gonna.
I'm the snake guy here.
So
I'm
anyways,
the oil guy.
15 minutes pass. A lot about Rattle's oil, which you did not know was a thing before just now.
Lights are still off, still screaming, probably.
I feel smarter, though.
Suddenly there's a...
Good.
You kind of feel like there's less screaming than there was before, but still plenty of confusion. Okay.